Did you see the picture?
I did.
What'd you
saw
think?
Saw it in the press screening. Hi, how are you?
Good. My name is Minsa. I'm one of the producers for the AMC documentary that's following Toronto Film Festival.
Okay.
And, you know, we're just basically following his process.
Okay.
Would it be all right if we filmed the interview?
It would. We're just kind of in a massive hurry, so we're going to, and it's going to be a little shorter. Absolutely. Okay, wing it.
What do you think of the movie?
We trust you. It's good.
You liked it?
Yeah.
More than Factory Girl?
You know, Factory Girl, I still have weird, you know, like mixed things about. I was not on the dark side of that, I don't think, as I recall. Mm. But then again, it's a long time ago. I don't think I liked her as much as some people. But I think I don't know.
How'd the screening go? The critic screening go?
It played well. I mean, I think the audience, everybody laughed and, you know. Okay. It's an interesting balance of having, are you rolling, honey? Mm-hmm. It's an interesting balance of having, you know, somebody like Lovitz and somebody like Spacey together, and then you have Barry, right, who actually is somewhere in the middle in terms of his career, and it looks like an interesting, odd balance.
But I always look at it in terms of storytelling. It's like trying to look at the context outside of what's happening in the movie.
Well, and that seems to be part of the theme of the movie, is figuring out history and, you know, mixing it efficiently.
When the tone of the story was so gothic, Jack and Rousseau was so gothic and so Shakespearean, it was humorous. It was almost, it was better than fiction, you know. Mm-hmm. And you know, and I like the challenge of balancing drama with comedy, the tonal challenge of that. I looked at Sidney Lumet's film Network over and over again, which is a, you know, a satire on one hand. You've got Peter Finch, I'm as mad as hell, I'm going to take it anymore. And then you've got these really intimate scenes with William Holden and his wife when he's fucking Faye Dunaway. And I like that balance of tone. You know, I think it's been a long time.
Chayefsky is not a bad place to aspire.
Yeah, no, Chayefsky is one of my favorites. But I like to, I think the cinema today, there's, you know, because it's so hard and so challenging to find a place in the marketplace, people make movies that are like, this, it's a satire. They're kind of almost genre-based or stylized-based or fashionista-based. And I like movies that are story-based. I like Howard Hawks, I like Sidney Lumet, I like John Ford. Those are the guys I aspire to, you know, who inspire me.
But history is part of, I mean, this is the second film in a row that's taken a historical figure. Is that just coincidence, or is that some way that you find yourself getting?
Well, it's funny, because I never, you know, I start off as a documentarian, and I love documentaries. And I'm just finding true-to-life stories kind of more interesting now. I don't know why. Maybe that's because I did, you know, Hearts of Darkness and Mare of the Sunset Strip. But I thought Abramoff was interesting on kind of, you know, Louis Malle once told me, I had the good fortune of having sort of be a mentor figure, told me, you know, it's always dangerous to think in terms of metaphors. But taking that risk, I will say that Abramoff sort of represented to me the idealism that's gone wrong in America, this kind of, you know, the American history, what's so unique about the United States and what people love about the country historically, and speaking in broad terms, is a sense of individualism, that frontiersman, the Western, that iconic, and that, but with that individual responsibility comes a sense of social responsibility, stewardship. I think Ronald Reagan epitomized that in the 1980s. Mm-hmm. I think that's what he brought the United States back from this horrible cultural malaise. What I think happened in the conservative movement, which is more Randian, which is, you know, about the individual, is that it became about me, the culture of avarice, the culture of greed, and that is what has poisoned and corroded Washington and Hollywood, too. But I think everything is commodified now, quantified, and I think when you live that way, you start to lose a sense of perspective, a sense of yourself, a sense of the individual, and I think Abramoff was an individual with aspirations, idealized aspirations, run amok.
So did you find, were you the originator? Did you find the book and move forward?
No, there was no book. There was only the New York Times, Washington Post, Washington Times, and Drudge. Norm Snyder is a journalist, Canadian journalist, great writer. He wrote Dead Ringers for Cronenberg. I found him. He wrote the script doing research. He interviewed people who knew Scanlon and Abramoff. And then what happened was I wanted to make the picture. I saw Bill Moyers' PBS documentary, Capital Crimes. Excuse me, I have a little bit of a cold. I wanted to make the picture. We got Norman, and then ultimately I got a hold of Abramoff through a mutual acquaintance, and Abramoff agreed to meet me in prison. And so I visited him in the Cumberland State Penitentiary 5 times. Mm-hmm. I brought Kevin the 5th time, which is interesting. We met in the warden's office. What's interesting about Jack Abramoff is, he was a very successful lobbyist because he is so charming, so charismatic, so funny, and there's something kind of seductive about his charm. Mm-hmm. But he does great impersonations, and you know, at one point, you know, Kevin was talking to Jack as Bill Clinton, and Jack was talking to Kevin as Ronald Reagan. So it was like this presidential summit.
In jail.
But what I think came out of that meeting for all of us was a sense of who Jack was. I mentioned anti-heroes.
Right.
I like to empathize with them. I mean, a lot of Hollywood development people are like, the character has to be sympathetic. No, they get confused. The character has to be empathetic. Some of the greatest anti-heroes of all time, Travis Bickle, you know, right. You want to marry him, but you identify with his loneliness, right? Norman Bates, mm-hmm. right, is a victim of his mother before we realize he is his mother, right?
Right.
Bonnie and Clyde. I love anti-heroes. I love that idea of ambiguity of ethos and ethics and social mores, and I like to explore that idea, and you know, because no one is good, purely good or purely bad. We all have those very shades of color in our character, and I wanted to explore that.
So when you bring a film like this to Toronto, is that, and you're trying to sell it here as well, is that experience nerve-wracking for you? Is it as hard as making the movie? Is it harder? Is it different?
Dude, I've been beaten up so much in my career. It's all uphill. it's fine. We sold the picture. We sold it to ATO, which is Dave Matthews' company. Dave Matthews, the singer, mm-hmm. songwriter, started a distribution called ATO stands for Art Takes Off. Art Takes Over. Art Takes Over,
right.
And it's their first film, and they've got a good P&A commitment. We've got Tom Ortenberg running our P&A campaign, so we're going to try to get some award consideration, knock on wood. You never know what happens, and see what happens.
So are you looking forward to opening night? You're just a couple nights away now.
I'm looking forward to opening night. It's a highlight of my career. Toronto's been a big supporter of my films. They've shown almost all my work, more than any of the festivals, consistently have embraced me, and so I have a loyalty to the festival, but I also think it's the most important festival in the world now. I think it's Eclipse Cannes and mm-hmm. Sundance in terms of English-speaking cinema.
Right.
And I think the Canadians have impeccable taste. And
so are you watching Biting Your Nails and nervously?
Not really. I'm not that nervous about it. I mean, I've been through test screenings. I worked for Harvey Weinstein. trust me, nothing makes me nervous.
As long as you don't have to do it again.
No, I'd work with Harvey again in a minute. Are you kidding? I think he's one of the most important things that happened in American cinema in the last 30 years. I love Harvey. I think he can be a total asshole, but I do love him. I think he's great, impeccable taste, and he was a great producer. It was a bit like being sodomized, but it is what it is. But he's a great producer. I'd work with him in a minute.
So
sure.
We get the Harvey Weinstein movie. Is that the appropriate?
There is a Harvey Weinstein documentary being made.
Jack Abramoff.
Yeah,
he's the Jack Abramoff of movies.
Maury Chaykin, who's in my film, played yes. Harvey on Entourage, right? God bless Maury. I'm really sorry.
And is that Maury's last role, or?
I believe it is. Yeah, it was like he's like Maury Chaykin. He's like a brand. He's like a Canadian Brando.
Yes,
he's so
he
good.
But you get a really beautifully intimate performance. Usually, people hire him to do that big over the top thing.
Yeah.
And even though his character is big here, you get a very intimate,
yeah.
Quiet kind of Maury Chaykin.
Well, I wanted to do that because Big Tony, the mob guy, is based on a true guy. Those are caricatures, and I wanted some layers there. So I wanted to get a great actor who could, and then Maury was great. Real blessing to work with him.
So you're happy with the movie?
I'm very happy with the movie.
And
I think it's sold. It's sold.
And now
on to the next.
On to the next. You ready for that? Do you know what the next thing's going to be?
I think so. Doing a movie with Pierce Brosnan, and I think Uma Thurman will know on Tuesday.
And in 3D?
In 3D. In 4D.
4D.
Man, my movies are in 4D, dude. It's called How to Make Love Like an Englishman.
Mm-hmm.
It's an autobiography. No, I'm just kidding. It's not. It's a cute romantic comedy. It's fun. It's very commercial, but it's smart. And I love Pierce. He's mm-hmm. he's a great actor, and I think it's a great role for him.
So we'll see him in here next year.
Hopefully, knock on wood.
Excellent. Thank you so much.
Hey, David. It's good. Always a pleasure. Thank you.